morning, Charging Wildcats. Today is Monday, November 8th, which means it's National Cappuccino Day. On the main desk, I'm Farrah Holman.
And on the virtual studio, I'm Brooklyn Bonner. Today is also National Parents as a Teacher's Day. For now, let's get into today's news. Starting off this week is Matilda the Musical. If you did purchase a ticket, it will be delivered to your B1 teacher sometime this week, so you can watch it this Friday.
All students who have a ticket will be released from class to see the musical, which will start around 9:30 a.m. And all students who are not attending will refer to their normal schedule.
The musical will additionally be held outside of school hours. These times will be Thursday, November the 11th at 7 p.m., Saturday, November 13th at 1 p.m. and 7 p.m., and lastly, Sunday, November 14th at 3 p.m. And now for this week's weather, let's turn to Marisol.
Hey y'all, Halloween just happened, which means it's finally Thanksgiving season. I really like the cold weather, so let's take a look into what this week's forecast has for us. Monday, we can see that it starts out with warmer weather than we've been having, with highs in the 70s. But on Thursday, there is a 40% chance of rain, and with that comes a cold front like we've been seeing lately. So let's jump into our daily forecast. Monday will be partly cloudy skies with a high of 72 and a low of 48. Tuesday will also be partly cloudy skies with a high of 74 and a low of 53. Wednesday will be cloudy with a high of 73 and a low of 54. And Thursday, there's that 40% chance of rain that I said, with a high of 70 and a low of 49. As we jump into our weekend, Friday will be pretty good weather for a game. It will be cold. At this moment when I'm recording, I do not know who we're playing, but the high will be 65 and the low will be 37. Saturday will be partly cloudy skies with a high of 59 and a low of 33. And Sunday will also be partly cloudy skies with a high of 55 and a low of 34. And that's the weather.
Next up, our Theater Arts Forensics team competed at Parkview High School Classic. Kinsey Tatum and Macy Knapp placed third place in duo interpretation.
Kinsey Tatum also placed third in original oratory, and Macy Knapp got third place in storytelling. Congratulations to all the students who competed.
Abby Reed, Ansley Albright, Angela Gwynn, Chris Orr, and Braden Dickey competed in statewide virtual anatomy and physiology contest. Way to go, guys.
AYAA is the Arkansas Young Artists Association, and this year they have decided to have an on-site event. The fall deadline is on November 12th and will require a $20 entry fee to be turned in at the same time as the filled out permission slip.
If you cannot make the November 12th deadline, there will be a spring registration deadline available in January. Students that are interested in participating in the AYAA art competition will need to contact Ms. R. Winsel to get the permission slip and categories list.
The NLR competitive cheer team won big in Morrilton with a 0-point routine. They won in best cheer, best use of tumbling, best pyramid, best use of stunts, first place in 6A overall girls, and lastly, overall grand champions with the highest scoring routine. And now, for more sports news, let's go up to the hill.
Sticking up, no rubber band is big enough. Tennis so heavy, can pick it up. Came with the gang, a myriad. I see you with hilarious. Where's my root mysterious? My whip from fast and furious. Curtains with yellow interior. I get the calmest period. Covered in ice, Siberia. I'm at the top of the pyramid. Storm serious. We gonna play serious. Came with the gang, a myriad.
How's it going, Wildcats? I'm Jake, and we're back with sports news. Congratulations to the cross-country team for completing their season at the state meet last Thursday. Also, let's give another congratulations to the swim team for finishing their first meet they just had last Tuesday. Peyton Price, Jordan Miller, Maddox Bowen, Lily Ruff, Hudson Cameron, and I all placed first in our individual events that we swam. For a quick recap of the meet, here's some highlights.
Yeah. Ride with the mob, alhamdulillah. Check in with me and do your job. Berg is the name, Bimbola did the chain. Torn off for the watch, Prezi plain Jane. Yamagini chain, rest in peace to my superior. Hermes linker, feed a village in Liberia. TMZ taking pictures, causing my hysteria. Mama see me on BT and start tearing up. I'ma start killing niggas, how you get that tripe? I attended Harlem picnics where you risk your life. Uncle used to skim works.
Our next meet is today at Russellville. After that, we have a Lone Oak meet on December 2nd. So come on out and cheer on those Wildcats. It's that time again. It's basketball season. Tomorrow, we have a blue and gold scrimmage. So come on out and go crazy for those Cats. Max Prep currently has our boys basketball team ranked number 6 in the nation. That's insane. But now it's time for football. Congratulations for Braxton Johnson for being named Player of the Week by Pulaski County Farm Bureau. Last week, we took on Cabot at their home stadium, and here's Marisol with the recap.
Hey Wildcats, it's Marisol and I'm back with another game recap. We did just win our last conference game of the season, 41-26 against the Cabot Panthers, and we are the third seed in our conference this year.
So this week, we'll have a playoff game on Friday here at our home stadium against Fort Smith Southside. Hope to see all y'all there. I'm Jake, and I'm out.
Christmas is around the corner, and the city of North Little Rock has a number of events planned we want to tell you about. Tomorrow is the Mayor's Holiday Tree Lighting Ceremony. It will take place at the Argenta Plaza at 6 p.m.
The city has also announced the return of the annual Northern Lights Holiday Celebration. This will take place at the Argenta Plaza on Saturday, November 20th from 3 p.m. to 8:30 p.m.
The celebration will have food trucks and a holiday market. It will also have live entertainment. There will be a holiday activities and families will be able to take pictures of Santa and the 38-foot Christmas tree.
Lastly, the city will also be holding a Christmas parade named A Family Christmas on Sunday, December 5th.
There will be one Santa who will be sponsored by the North Little Rock Convention Center, but anyone or any group may participate. All entries must have entertainment appeal and must be costumed or decorated. All clubs, organizations, schools, churches, and businesses are encouraged to participate.
Drivers of 3 or 4-wheelers must be at least 18 years of age. No walking entries that perform will be allowed other than school bands with drill teams, military units, and adult walking units. And finally, all children and children groups will be required to be in vehicles for safety reasons.
And finally, as we do every week, we will now play the Star Spangled Banner, and this time it will be performed by Zane Bisher.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that a flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? and the home of the brave.
And that's all the news we have for you today, Wildcats. Remember that if you have any announcements or comments, you can contact us via email at nlrtv@nlrsd.org.
And don't forget to follow us on Twitter at NLRTV4, on Instagram at NLRTV_NLRHS, and on our Facebook page at North Little Rock TV. And please subscribe to our NLRTV YouTube channel.
Have a great day, Wildcats!
Next up, our Theater Arts Friznik. I can't pronounce that word.
If you didn't purchase a ticket, it will be delivered. If you did purchase a ticket, if you didn't.
Hey, y'all. No. Oh, my God. I can't do it.
Our director seems to be having a mental breakdown right now, so we are having technical difficulties, people. I'm sorry. All right. Let's go through this again.
A pill and must be costume or decorated all club. Yeah.
Okay. For now, let's get into that. Into what? I'm sorry.
So this week we'll have a playoff game on Friday here at our home stadium.
Which way does that go? This way to this way? Do it again. I could do that. It's just quite large hand.
Four on Instagram at NLRTV_NLRHS and on our Facebook page at North Little Rock TV. And please subscribe to
So this week we'll have a playoff game on Friday here at our home stadium against Springdale, against Rogers Heritage, here at our stadium. I hope to see all y'all there. I'm Jake, and I'm out.